Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing amazing. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how I edit my Instagram style videos. This has been highly requested and I finally come to making it. I'm a little bit of a perfectionist. I've literally recorded this video about 3 times because I'm like, I haven't got like the perfect video to show you guys, but today I'm going to be showing you guys step by step on how I basically start from editing to picking out your music. And yeah, let's just get right into the video. To start off with, you're gonna need a video, of course, but you're not just gonna need any ordinary video. You always have to have a goal in mind or a sort of end goal of how you want your video to look. And that will be down to how you create the video. So it is not in the editing of the video that makes the video, it is in the making of the video that makes the video. I always like to go on Instagram and save Instagram style videos so that I can go back and reference from. So when I'm recording, I will pick out a video that I like and I will sort of recreate it. Basically like take some inspiration. I wouldn't exactly like recreate it. And I definitely advise if it's something that you'll want to go into, definitely create a folder on Instagram and go back and reference from. The videos I like to make are those kind of videos where you've basically got the garment and then you put it on and voila, you're wearing the garment. I love editing those kind of videos and I also love, you know, watching them. So that's what I'm gonna be showing you guys today. When I'm recording the video, I always make sure that I have like different kind of start and transitions so that when it comes to editing, you basically pick and choose which one you want, because it can become, you know, there's nothing worse when you recorded the video and then when it comes to editing and it just doesn't go with the next clip. So it's always nice to have a variety. When I'm starting, I always like to pick a really good you know, starting a video, but so I would skim through literally the whole of the video for the first outfit and look at like my, I would say, selling point. You wanna attract the audience, I would say, in the first 10 seconds. So definitely just skim through what you really like. And for this outfit, I just literally just, I would go in and I would split clip and then I would sometimes delete, or you know, I would just play about and see which one works. So when I'm doing one outfit, I would do it all, just the first outfit, and then I would go on to my next outfit and I would basically go back and look at how it looks like before I proceed on to my next outfit. This just basically helps you cancel any time at the end. You know, you don't want to, you know, edit all this video and then in the end you have to come back and have a look at all the footage and then you don't like it and you've already deleted a, you know, a video that you recorded. It's just a lot more time consuming, so I like to just do it step by step for the first outfit and then the next. When it comes to me showing you guys how I put on the jacket, as I go and skim through the video, when I'm making the video, I would stop. I would show you guys me putting the jacket, and then when now I'm editing, I would go through the video. When I'm recording, I would have done like me maybe just touching the jacket. I would cut where that clip is and I would put that next to the other one, and you can basically just go back and forth and see if the transition did work. So the next transition is me tapping onto the top, and miraculously I'm wearing a different top. For this is literally the same way. So when I'm wearing the other top, I would stop in the same place, I would tap on my shoulder and I would wait a few seconds, and then when I change, I go back on the same spot. I make sure that my foot and everything is positioned in the same way, and then I would show you guys how I put it on. It's pretty simple. This is what I basically do for all my transitions. It's pretty simple, but you just get the hang of it once you, you know, you do your first one, but you just have to just, you know, trial and error. So that's really it with editing my videos. I sometimes would add transitions. So I would go on the transition tab at the top and I would just pick out which transition I like. I would drag it down and I will, you know, basically see how it looks like. And also one thing to know, the reason why my videos are portrait mode is because that's how I record them. And if I basically flip it round, I don't really tend to see my facial expression like very close. So I basically edit like this. It's really weird, but it's just the best way to for me to see like the full outfit. But you can always like flip it back. I always like to do this just because when I'm exporting the video, I wanna export it in full. So you guys can already see that I already selected music for this video. I would say music is a super key for when you obviously making these Instagram style videos, because they are key to your video. I don't have a library of music, but what I like to do, I like to go on YouTube. I like to you know, look at a music that I like. And this is the other thing, I also like to go back and reference from any style videos that I liked on Instagram. I like to see what kind of videos they have. I would say if you have Shazam, it will be perfect for you to Shazam the music, but I think you're gonna need another phone to Shazam that music on your phone. Obviously, I have my playlist on Spotify. It's just like my, you know, normal playlist. When I'm listening to music, I always like to write music down that I like. So I would go on YouTube, I would type a music that I like. The music that I use was Dream Girl, the remix. And I will just go on YouTube, I will type that in, and I would take up the URL. It's actually come at the top, so that is what I want. And then I would take the URL, I would create a new tab, and then I always have this saved on my bookmark. So what I like to use is YouTube Converter. I would go on there, and I would paste that in there, and this easily exports your music as MP3 for free. So you download that on your desktop. I've already downloaded it, so I'm not gonna click on it again, but you basically just click on it and it will come at the bottom, and you just click on it and it will open. And once it's open, you would go on. So my music gets saved on iTunes, so I would go on iMovie, I would go on Audio. Actually, I ended up deleting it, so I'm gonna download that again and show you guys. And honestly, the only thing you need to do is just take it and drag it. And when you are playing the video, you just go in and cut whichever one you want. So I'm just gonna mute this for the sake of me having to obviously explain to you guys. Actually, I won't be able to explain it to you if I'm not muting it. So I would go in and I would cut, basically like split the music where I want it to start, and then I would drag it like that. Like that. That's not where I wanted to, so I'm just gonna go in and basically just play the music and cut where I want it to be. So now that I've cut where I want it to be, I normally like to put the music down to like 50, so you can move it around using this thing. I will put it 50, and sometimes I reduce it just so that it's not too impactful to the video. And then you just play it, and yeah, and there you have your video. And you can basically just like skim past, and you know, you play the video from the beginning and see if you like it or not. I feel like one tip to note, if you are getting bored in the first 10 seconds, then change something about your video. Maybe add like a transition to, you know, help the video. And yeah, that is just basically literally, yeah, everything. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope I was informative enough. If I've missed anything out, then do let me know. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and I will see you guys on my next video.